this room right here was the room where the last person who lived in this house died. And he died sitting in an armchair right here, watching television in the corner there, and was found on the floor here. Now his face used to come up through the tiles.
Explain the face, what exactly did it look
like? Well, the face was the profile of the guy who died there on the floor, and where they found him there. For the first 3 months, we'd lay more tile down and come back up through it. So that's why I had the contractor lay down cement so it would stop. There was like a tornadic storm that came through, and it knocked down about 20 trees in the graveyard here. And all these trees that you see in the picture here, all the little ones, were all knocked down. And they formed a perfect hexagram around Dr. Rhodes' spire. That spire is James B. Rhodes, M.D., one of the, I guess, about the fourth doctor in Dawson County. Born November 24, 1861, and died April 14, 1899. The next day, after we put the plaque up, sitting in the front room with my general manager, talking about the business after work, hear a thunk, and I come out, and the plaque's on the floor. I hung the plaque back up and tightened the screws in and turned the little kitty corner so it would be tight. And the next night, we're out in the front room again. Thunk, it's on the floor. I spread the screws apart, used bigger headed screws, locked the thing in so you couldn't hardly move it. Next night, thunk, the plaque's on the floor. I said, this is ridiculous. It must be trucks going by, causing vibration, making it jump off the screws. So I glued it to the wall, in addition to the big screws, immobile, right? No, the next night, thunk, it's on the floor, and all the wallpaper that's on top of this particle board pulled off with it. 3 days later on a Saturday, my cleaning guy's in the back here. Now he's buffing the floors, and doing all this good stuff that he likes to make it very nice. And I had a poster sitting on this countertop, and he's buffing here in the nurse's station. Well, the poster rose up off the countertop, floated over, and lay on the floor. And he thought maybe the air from the buffer had got under it, so he turned his buffer off, picked it up, went around, put it back down on the counter nice and careful. And as he's standing here, the poster rises up, floats over on the floor. He freaks out, runs up front where I'm sitting doing paperwork, and is yelling and screaming. I said, it's all right, it's all right. And when I'm here late at night, right there under the frame where I put my arch in to keep the roof sustained, I'll be back here doing my charts, turn out the light, and I turn and there's a figure standing there. A little portly, in a great coat with a Chester A. Arthur beard. And I'll usually do a double take and catch my breath, and then he's gone. The last known picture of Dr. James P. Rhodes, M.D., little portly, great coat, Chester A. Arthur beard. At night, we'll be in the building and you'll hear footsteps, and footsteps descending the stairs, but not find anybody. On several different occasions, my general manager, my front desk person, has been out here with no one in the waiting room and seen a figure, not portly, but a little thinner, also in antique dress, if you will, of the 1800s, cross the lobby and go up the stairs. And they've gone up to look for somebody that's obviously gone upstairs when it's private, where we have a private office, and there's no one there. And I've been sitting at this desk many times doing my books at night, and I'll hear a cough, or I'll hear talking out in my waiting room, and I go, and of course, there's no one there. It's freaked out my staff. They're afraid sometimes to go upstairs at night and turn off the light, especially in the fall when a lot of this activity picks up.
So when you took the house over, it was like bedrooms up here?
Yeah. You'll hear footsteps usually starting from in the back here. And this is usually where you hear the voices from, right around this area. These things have been going on since we opened the place. And,